of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus. a traditional blessing of wine that takes place on that day. So, well, even though we'll be celebrating the Feast of the Family, we will be blessing the wine. If you would like to bring the wine after the 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. Masses, we'll bless wine then. Tuesday, January 5th, is the eve of the Epiphany. We'll be blessing Epiphany water and salt at 7 p.m. after Adoration. It's a special blessing that can only be given once per year. If you would like to bring your container of water, please do so. If you'd like to bring multiple containers of water, I would ask that they be at least a gallon in size. I have had people bring in pallets of water bottles before. It's hard to get all the salt into each single one. So try to cut down on the time and labor. And then finally, Wednesday, January 6th, is the Epiphany. After Mass, we'll have the traditional blessing of gold, incense, and myrrh. I know many of you have stockpiles of myrrh in your house and are looking forward to having it blessed. Also, a blessing on chalk, if you'd like to take chalk home with you to bless your own house, or if you'd like me to come and bless your house, please call the office by that Monday so that you can get on the list. That is kind of first come, first served as far as that list goes. We do have Christmas gifts. They should be amply stocked in the back and then also over at the side for everyone. And then if you we do have some children here, we do have some gifts in the back. If you'd like to take some back of those to some children, that would be fine as well. The candy canes, though, are for the children. Finally, just so that we're all on the same page, today, because of the special emphasis on the Incarnation, the part of the creed where we normally would bow, we all genuflect at that time today. So. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. All right, halfway through midnight Mass is the most exciting, I think it's the most exciting one, to me personally. I really like midnight Mass. In the celebration of our Lord's nativity, of his birth, Merry Christmas. That's all we can say, right? That's what we have to say. I have to say that I was reading some of the Church Fathers in the Matins today, and Pope Gregory the Great, when he was talking, says, well, I have to see some. By the grace of God, I'm celebrating three Masses today, so I will have to be rather brief. But I do have to say something. Well, I got you, Greg, because I'm celebrating four. So we will try to be a bit condensed, but at the same time, we, as St. Gregory says, do want to say something. And I have to say that every time Christmas rolls around, I'm always drawn to thinking of a couple of different things. One is, which of the Christmas Carol films I will watch? It is either George C. Scott or Patrick Stewart. You choose. I think they're both great, but the question is, which one am I going to choose this year? And so you have that. And here's the thing, is that it's a wonderful movie, it's a wonderful idea, and it's great, except kind of the message is just a little bit distorted. It's a little bit off. I think it might have something to do with the fact that Dickens is a big atheist. I don't know. But the reality is that at the end of the movie, our thing is that I think there has to be more to it than just those things. And I think that we know that that is the case. But what can we say? And I really liked reading Pope Leo the Great just now. And he says, this is the birthday celebration of life itself. Happy birthday, life. It is the way he writes, I wish I could, in some ways, I wish I could just grab his copy and just kind of read it to you instead of giving one to myself. But the way he says, he talks about that we're celebrating the birth of he who is life. He who is light in darkness. The world before Christ is filled with darkness. There's a hopelessness about our existence that no longer holds true because he who is life, he who is light, because Christ the Lord is born. Our Savior is born to us today. St. Leo says today, he said, it would be unlawful for us to be sad today. That's what he says. It would be unlawful for us to be sad today. He says, if you are a saint already, then you know you should be overflowing with joy because you've come that much closer to what he says, grasping the palm of triumph. And if you are a sinner, then your pardon is at hand. And if you are a pagan, you are invited to life. I wonder about those sentiments, the idea that our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, is born today. There are a lot of other things that happen during the Christmas season, of which we are certainly aware. There is that feeling of generosity that we kind of get. Yes, there's the stress and the having to go around and make sure everything is done and taken care of. But in addition to that, there is a certain joy in doing those things, in the cooking and the baking, in the spending time with our families. These things are not, in and of themselves, the meaning of Christmas. The meaning of Christmas is to do with salvation being born to us. The light that enlightens every heart has entered the world. And yet, at the same time, they're not distant from that reality. All of those trappings of Christmas, all of the things that bring us joy, those pleasant memories that we have, and the warmth that we feel, this all can be directed and ought to be directed toward acknowledging the presence of Christ in our life. I have to say that when I was a kid, I was quite selfish as a child. the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Through him all things are made. Cross, thank you for our salvation. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and may be followed. We may be found in the likeness of Christ, and all. some of my own that was in it. He took this precious chalice and his holy and noble hands. Once more giving you thanks, he said a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, our Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. We please to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as also at least accept the gifts of your servant, able to just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father of faith, and the offering of the high priest and the peace of David, the holy sacrifice, as long as faith. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high inside the word of our majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gathered forth with the sign of faith and rest in the city.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Amen. And I pray that this Holy Communion may not be for me an offense to be punished,